Hi there, this is Lynn Allen. Thanks for joining me for another AutoCAD tip, thanks to Cadalyst Magazine. So today I'm going to share with you a tip that I was reminded of when I was looking at the Imagine It's blog. I like to give people credit. It's the good old time command. I used to teach this to my students a long time ago. So this is for those of you who are very conscientious and you want to know exactly how much time you spent working in an AutoCAD join, or you're just curious, or sometimes, which it's best not to know. Or I would say the time command also comes in handy if somebody's been working on a drawing, they told you they worked on it for 10 hours, and you come in here, it says they only worked in it for 8. Well, then I'd kind of want to know what the deal was. Just saying. So if you take a look at the time command, it's very simple, right? It tells you when it was created. You can see the drawing's, over 5 years old, when the last time it was updated, the last time that it was saved. And this is it right here, the total editing time. And incidentally, that's minus plot time. It doesn't count plot time, which is good. And you'll also see that there's a timer. It really should be the exact same number as the editing time, because as soon as you open the join, the timer is turned on. But we're gonna change that actually here in a second. And then the next time there's going to be an automatic save. If for some reason you want to know that information, if it's important to you. And so first off, I'm gonna turn the timer. I'm gonna turn it off. All right, so now we're going to sit around for a second and talk about the weather. And the weather's pretty nice here in Northern California. All right, now let's take a look at, let's do display again. And you will see now that the timer has a lower amount of time than the editing time, right? Because we turned the timer off. All right, well, what if you wanted to time yourself doing something in AutoCAD? I have no idea why. Maybe you're having a race with somebody else in the office to see who can get something done the fastest. Well, then you can reset the timer. Let's reset it. Let's do display to look at it. And you will see now that the timer is off and it's set to 0. Okay, so now you and your buddy are going to have a race to see how long it takes to do heaven only knows what. And so then you're going to come back and you're going to say on. All right, I'm going to go out of the command. Let's come back over here and just blah, blah, blah. We draw some lines, we do whatever. You just do whatever, whatever, whatever. Okay, you have your race is over, you go back into the time command, and you will be able to see exactly how much time it took for you to do it. You'd probably want to stop it right then and there, right? You would say off so that it didn't continue to keep time. And then when your friend caught up, because you're of course faster than he is, then you'd be able to truly claim that you were the winner because you used the time command. Oh yeah, hey, comes in handy. Great for billing back and things like that. You can prove how much time you spent in a drawing file. All right, so use the time command. Thanks for joining me, and I will see you back here in 2 more weeks.